Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Commexis Cast Daily for Thursday, November 2nd, 2017. All the news you need to know from our inbox to yours. I'm Matthew McGrorty, the videographer and podcaster here at Commexis. And today, I am joined by the lead strategist at Commexis, Phillip Brooks.
Good morning.
And the president of Commexis, Len Ward.
Good morning.
So for our first story today, Facebook has jumped in profits 79% for their third quarter, and their revenue is continuing to increase. This is from a report by Deepa Samatharan at the Wall Street Journal. So Facebook reported a third quarter profit of $1.59 a share, which is up 90 cents a share from a year ago, and they also generated $10.33 billion in revenue, which is up from the $7.01 billion in the prior year's quarter. So they're making more money and their share is going up, but Mark Zuckerberg has talked about how, given the scrutiny that is coming towards Facebook, given the Russian ad scandal and a couple other things, that they're going to be doubling the number of employees and contractors who handle safety security issues to 20,000 by the end of 2018, which is expected to make their expenses rise in 2018 by 60%. So they're making more money, but they're also going to be spending a whole lot more of it. And they said that one of the article mentions that Facebook said 146 million users saw the post from accounts linked to the Internet Research Agency, which is the agency that was the pro-Kremlin ad creator. And Mark Zuckerberg, in a quote, said, "I am dead serious about this. I've directed our teams to invest so much in security on top of other investments we're making that it will significantly impact our profitability going forward."
No, it won't. I understand what he's trying to say, and I know that it's going to cost a lot of money, but I think what we're setting up here is for Facebook beat earnings again next quarter, and the stock goes up. I could be wrong. I know that they're going to make an investment. A couple of things I thought was really interesting in the Facebook report in the numbers was they talked about, and I have the email on my phone here, that's why I'm doing this, I'm not avoiding the camera. They talked about how the mid-roll ads, it's actually, people are watching all the way through on the mid-roll ads, which I thought was very interesting. But a very interesting point they made there was that the Facebook ads are now getting more expensive. Mm-hmm. And we've been telling clients for a while that Facebook is a very, very affordable medium that you mandatory have to be on. B2B, B2C, I don't care what you're doing, you need to be doing Facebook retargeting, you need to have money in Facebook. But they're beginning to preface it now that it's costing more money because you're getting obviously more and more competition in the front door. Mm-hmm. So if you're running Facebook ads and you're, you know, maybe if you're kind of out of tilt where you know your pay-per-click budget say $2,500 a month, but yet your Facebook budget's only say $250 or $300 a month, Facebook knows that. And they want a part of Google's money. So I think you need to start allocating a little bit money, more money towards Facebook. And you really need to start getting the ratio to maybe 60-40, 70-30 in that realm. So if you have overall $3,000 to spend on paid, you at the bare minimum right now to be competitive on Facebook, I think you should be at about 1,000 and with 2,000 on Google. However, again, I'm not buying this that it's going to impact the earnings next quarter. I could be wrong. We could sit here next quarter and I'd be completely wrong. You know, I think Facebook is literally in the beginning of where it's really going to go. I can't say enough about it. Yeah. We see conversions, clients see conversion. If you're not advertising on Facebook, you're making a grave mistake right now.
Yeah, I think what's interesting about this, and another article that we read touched on this a little bit, was that, you know, obviously, it's bad that some propaganda was able to be spread by this Russian entity. But at the same time, it kind of shows how effective Facebook ads are.
Oh,
even
yeah.
though it's very scary that this happened,
yeah.
it just goes to show, like, hey, this is how much effect Facebook ads
it's,
can have.
When this is finished happening, when this investigation finishes, it's going to be a case study on how internet advertising works. So I think it's going to be, you know, it's really proving their value, and I think that's a huge point. But you mentioned something about mid-roll ads with Facebook, and that kind of dovetails into the next story that I have, which is Ross Bennis has basically a compilation of really interesting statistics about ad fraud and how things are going on Digiday. So just to throw some numbers at you, video ad spend doubled from $7.7 billion in 2015 to $13.2 in 2017, according to eMarketer, and it's expected to exceed $18 billion by 2020. But here's where it kind of gets goes off the rails. Video accounts for 45% of total ad spend, but it is tied to 64% of all ad fraud. So that's a huge percentage. And what they're saying is that this ad fraud is happening more commonly in the richer, kind of more higher CPM channels. So over the top traffic specifically is almost all, is 20% of bots. And that's over the top meaning Netflix, Hulu, streaming services that don't need to be gated by access to your video platform. So if you're not using your Comcast or Verizon, that kind of stuff. So that's a big piece, and that's something that people need to really look into if you're looking to advertise on those mediums. And just an interesting final note, White Ops estimates that fraud accounts for up to 22% of video spend and 9% of display spend. So again, video is far more impacted by this than normal display and AdWords. So if you're looking to pivot into video, make sure your strategy does not employ some of these bots, heavy tactics.
Yeah. Well, thank you everybody for tuning into today's episode of the Commexis Cast Daily. Check us out tomorrow for more of the latest trending news. Have a great day.
Thanks.